Hello everyone, I'm Christian Wade and I'm a Program Manager for Analysis Services. Azure Analysis Services presents exciting automation opportunities for integration with DevOps processes and improved application lifecycle management. Whether transferring ownership of self-service BI to IT or simply moving to the cloud, it's easy to operationalize Azure Analysis Services, allowing greater agility to respond to changing business needs. With Azure Analysis Services, it's easy to quickly provision servers based on unforeseen usage trends without the overhead of configuring virtual machines. Automation of tasks such as build, deployment, and testing allows you to deliver with confidence that your processes are repeatable, predictable, and robust for business-critical applications. So let's dive in. Analysis Services is fully integrated with source code management systems such as TFS and GitHub. This enables automated build, deployment, and testing, and is one of the reasons to move to technical BI, which is owned by IT. In this case, I'm going to add a simple measure. We can see the file is flagged as having a pending change in the Solution Explorer. We can compare with the unmodified version from Git. The differences are highlighted in the easily readable JSON format. And in this case, I'm just going to revert back to the previous version. I'm now going to show how easy it is to automate provisioning of servers with Azure Analysis Services. If we click Add, type in some info. And instead of clicking on Create, I'm going to click Automation Options instead. And here we can see the ARM template files, including sample code in PowerShell and C#. We can download these files, which I did earlier. So I'm going to go ahead and run that script. Type in a server name. And it'll take a few seconds to provision the server, which is much faster than setting up a virtual machine, installing drivers, installing analysis services, and results in more consistency across environments as well due to less manual intervention. And there we are. There's our new server. I'm going to copy the server name because we'll need it in just a moment. So that's how quick and easy it was to automate the provisioning of a server. And I'm now going to run some PowerShell script to create a database and process it. We will use the invoke ASCMD commandlet for this purpose, which calls some tabular model scripting language commands. Paste in the server name. It's now creating the database. And it's processing it, getting the data from an Azure SQL Data Warehouse instance. And it's done. Switch over to Power BI Desktop. Paste in the server name. And there we are. To summarize what we just saw, source control integration with GitHub, automated server provisioning, database deployment, and data refresh, which can be integrated with build and deployment processes, and we then connected to the newly provisioned server with Power BI Desktop. As you can see, it's even easy to provision and then delete a whole server as part of an automated test run. And in the near future, we'll also support automated scale up, scale down, and pause, which will enable countless new scenarios to save on compute costs, such as scaling down servers when not in peak usage. And that's it. That's how easy it is to automate Azure Analysis Services. We encourage you to try out the preview, and we trust that Azure Analysis Services will enable you to build robust enterprise-class solutions for business-critical scenarios. Thank you for watching.